Hey guys, what is up? Ribbit Ribbit, cEDH for Frogs here. Today we're going to be talking about deck building and the way I approach deck building. I always am building new decks. When there's a new commander I find interesting comes out, or maybe I see something else that I want to bring in a different direction. All the time this happens, right? And you just think you can maybe do something better with an archetype, or maybe you just don't like the way that they're played. So you need to go and find a good process to building a deck. So in this video, we're going to go over that. Okay, guys, I'm going to be using 11 the Mage and Mike the Dungeon Master. Two new commanders, just been coming out, a little bit controversial, not everyone's happy with them. I myself haven't even watched the show, I just thought that Mike the Dungeon Master's ability to pay two colorless, tap, choose target creature card in your graveyard that's been put there this turn to return to the battlefield with partner seems kind of good. I thought I could get something going with that. So the first thing I did was I came in and I added all of the staples. So we added all of our mana dorks that we're definitely going to be running in these colors, a bunch of tutors that make sense in our sorceries, instants are your bare bones removal spells, Psychrift, Enlightened Tutor, because we're probably going to be running an artifact or enchantment worth tutoring. Swords, Vamp, World of Tutor, the rocks that you have to run in every deck, and a few enchantments. The lands are also already set up. That's basically, you just run your perfect duels that you have to. At the end, this could be tweaked depending on what your mana symbols look like down here. But you'll get to that when you get to that. To note, I did already add Phyrexian Tower because I thought sacrificing a creature pay 2 to return it with Mike seemed pretty good, as well as Cradle because I know I'm going wide. They're the unusual ones that you won't see in every deck. Other than that, it's pretty standard. Gemstone Caverns for ramp, Ancient Tomb, same thing. Pretty standard stuff outside of those lands. Alright, first thing we do is we think about what our deck is going to look like. So I know that Mike returning stuff is going to be pretty good with value creatures. So you're looking for things that you want to have either die a lot or things that you want to have enter the battlefield a lot. And a strategy that I know, and this won't always work for everyone, I'm able to do this because I've had a bit of experience running around, is I know that creatures that want to enter the battlefield and do stuff a lot, very good in Birthing Pod. So that's the first step, I think Birthing Pod. And let's go add a Birthing Pod and chuck it in. So then, if you want inspiration, you can jump over to another list, right? To get an idea. So we're going to be making 5 color Blood Pod, essentially. So if we jump over to Tana Timna Blood Pod, you can scroll through and get some ideas. So we look, first of all, we have Archon of Emeria, right? Rule of Lore effect. So we think, wow, yeah. Rule of Lore is a good idea, so let's chuck in Rule of Lore. We know that that's going to stop us from dying. Let's chuck in the Archon of Emeria. Let's chuck in the Aethersworn Canonist. Because we know that all of these cards are going to help us survive the game and perform. Because people can't Oracle us out of the game, we're going to have a very good chance of powering through with our grind. Arcane Lab is the blue variation of Rule of Lore that really no one plays. I guess it's because it dies to either Red Elemental Blast or Pyroblast, but it can be pitched to Force. So, interestingly enough, I think it should see a bit more play. Alright, let's keep going through. So we have Arza Oddsmaker. At the beginning of your combat, you may discard a card. Not that good. Let's keep going. Collector Oof, nuts. Alright, yeah, Collector Oof. We can stop people from playing, right? So we can chuck in a Collector Oof. What's like Collector Oof? Null Rod is like Collector Oof. Chuck in a Null Rod. Khan, the Great Creator. And don't be afraid when we go over our main board count, right? Because that's gonna happen. This is just the standard. Dark Confidant, yeah. Add some value cards. Dark Confidant, that seems good. We're going to be chucking in a Voidwalker, nuts. You get to repeat Voidwalker in this deck. Alright, let's keep going. Dockside, yep, Dockside is a must-have. Dockside extortionist is insane. Alright, let's keep going. Draneth. Yeah, more hate. Draneth Magistrate. So essentially we're going to be getting to about 100 and something cards in the main board after I go through this list. So I'm going to fast forward and do that and then return to a list of what I have after I've done that. And then we're going to continue making changes from there. Okay guys, we are back and I have the deck updated with all of the cards that I think do come over from the Blood Pod deck. So then we have to look at what we have and think how to make it more centered to the commander what we have. Because obviously if we just took exactly that Blood Pod deck, it would be a Tana Timna Blood Pod deck. It would not be an 11 and Mike Blood Pod deck. So what do we do to make what we have more focused around Mike? So first of all, we have to think, we have blue, so that means we get to run a bunch of blue cards that no one else, that they can't run. So we get things like Mystic Remora, we get things like Neoform that they don't get to run, but also means that we get the Dorks that they don't get to run. So for example, we get Noble Hierarch, which is nice and cute. So that's a good step into that direction. So what other nuts blue cards are there that we get to run? Okay, what's a good card that can go nice with Kiki Jiki? Alright, so we might run Pestermite because we have blue. So maybe we want to lead into the Pestermite or the Deceiver Exarch route to go more in that direction. I'm embarrassing myself with spelling. Alright, Deceiver Exarch. Yep. So that means, so yeah, we can go Splinter Twin, right? Seems good. Splinter Twin. And then we use this to just sort of develop a more full deck list, right? So then we go, alright, what sort of cards are actually kind of nuts with Mike? So, Ashnod's Altar, making things die and being able to pay for his ability to just return them to play, seems quite good. So getting Ashnod's Altar value with Mike seems very good. Ashnod's Altar and, where is it, with Village Bell Ringer is infinite ETBs and infinite untaps for your board. So that's a very fast way to getting infinite mana. That seems very good. So, we have that, right? What's another variation of Village Bell Ringer? We can think like that. Intruder Alarm. Intruder Alarm is another variation of Village Bell Ringer. So you can start thinking of things like that. So then we are adding Ashnod's Altar, right? So we might be looking at this, not the Khan, but the Null Rod and the Collector Roof is a bit less favorable. We're also on Birthing Pod, so that might be something to take in mind. Then you can think about other ways to win with Kiki Jiki, right? So what's another way to win with Kiki Jiki? Combat Celebrant is another way to win with Kiki Jiki. And then you can go, alright, cool. We've got Combat Celebrant. What's something that can go infinite with Combat Celebrant? And then you can go Derevi. Derevi can link in and it comes from the blue. Derevi untapping things like our Gaia's Cradle is good. Derevi entering and untapping Mike. So if you have Mike plus Derevi plus Ashnod's Altar, that's infinite as well. But it's only infinite enters. So then, making things die. Viscera Seer is a good way of getting things to die for good value. Also, Carrion Feeder is a good way of getting things to die for good value. And you can just start thinking like that to get into the game, right? So then another one that I was interested with is we go down to our Ranger Captain of Eos and we go, all right, here's a sacrifice ability. So does Darthy Voidwalker, another sacrifice ability. How do we abuse these sacrifice abilities? Well, Mike with Voidwalker means lots of Voidwalkers, right? Casting a lot of your opponent's cards for free seems actually very insane. But how can we go with that even further? So Ranger Captain of Eos. What if we could Ranger Captain of Eos, untapping our mic in everyone's turns? That would lock them out of the game, right? So Seedborn Muse has some utility there. Then we go, all right, but we're a Rule of Law deck, so and we don't run that many instants, and not much to do with our mana. All right, what's a good way of getting around that? Maybe running something like Thrasios, which also works as an infinite mana outlet in the deck, because we don't have one in the command zone. We have a lot of ways to make infinite with a sac outlet, and a dork if the dork has haste. Or if we could untap Mike. Okay. Maybe haste on everything is good. So we can move into world things. So maybe Concordant Crossroads could work. Then we look and go, alright, we need more tutors maybe? What's a creature repeatable tutor? Woodland Bellower. And this might be going a bit too high-end, but we're not running much high-end. Like, we could easily fit an Elesh Norn in here if we wanted to. We have a Cradle. We can cast big stuff like this. All right, then we think we have a Cradle, so Crop Rotation. We want to find that Cradle. We want a few other ways of drawing it. So Crop Rotation seems very, very good here. So this is how I sort of delve into making this stuff work. And then you can use your knowledge of the format again to go, alright, we're already running Village Bellringer, and we're already running Derevi, so that means we can run Emiel. Emiel the Blessed. Okay, we're running Emiel the Blessed, which means that we can flicker stuff, make a lot of treasures with a Dockside. How do we get value? How do we actually win the game? Because again, we don't have infinite mana in the command zone. But we are sacrificing a lot with our birthing pod. Okay, maybe a Mayhem Devil is a good way of dealing a bunch of damage to everyone. Seems like a solid win. So this is how I slowly put the deck together. And then I'll start trimming on stuff. So then I'll go through and go, maybe Dark Confidant isn't that good. So move to considering, because 11 is already essentially a Dark Confidant. And I trim away like that. How many times does Khan the Great Creator actually the spell I want to cast? You think about it and you go, no, yes, Khan is quite good. Maybe you look down and you go, Pestermite. Does Pestermite look like my main win? Am I actually going to Splinter Twin? Maybe I'm running too many things. I'm already on MEO lines, I'm on Splinter Twin lines, I'm on Kiki Jiki lines, I'm on Birthing Pod, Yisan. Alright, sure. Maybe that goes to considering for a while. And this is just sort of how I begin to trim away at what's already in the deck. I find this is the best way. And then after I'm done, I will always go to Reddit, go to Discords. I'm in the 11 Discord, and I'll post it into the chat. And ask, hey guys, is there anything I'm missing that's obvious? Because even if you think you're the greatest Magic player on Earth, sometimes you miss some really obvious stuff. So, that's essentially it. Okay guys, again, ribbit ribbit, that was the video. So that's basically the summary of how I go about building a new deck when a new commander comes out, or I want to make a new variation of another deck. So maybe I could have taken that Tim Natana deck and made it more Kiki Jiki oriented, or maybe took away from the Kiki Jiki and left it just to the pod, or you know, something like that. That's a good example of how I go around doing that sort of thing, and I will do this process for every deck. It can be time consuming, but if you want to take control and build decks like really good decks and something that you can get noticed for, I myself have the leading primer on Old Stickfingers at the moment. I'm one of the main authors on that. So I did this process to get that going essentially. Stickfingers a bit weirder, there wasn't another deck to really look at. I sort of looked on the Gitrog monster to get an idea of what sort of protection to run, what sort of discard outlets to run, etc. to make Stickfingers work. So yeah, the Old Stickfingers Death Sticks deck, if you can check that out, I'll link that below as well. Very good fun. And yeah, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I will see you all later. Please subscribe down below. Like the video if you enjoyed yourself. Thank you for sticking around this far. Join the Discord. That will be down below as well. Have a good one. Ciao. See you all next time.